If you are planning a career in cybersecurity in 2026, there's one thing that you can't ignore. That is AI. It's everywhere, from SOC to pen testing, from risk analysis to incident response. If you don't understand how AI is being used in cybersecurity right now, you are going to be left behind your peers. So today in this video, I'm going to talk about the top 5 places in which AI is being used in cybersecurity right now. Hi everyone, my name is Meera Tamboli. I work in cybersecurity in the UK and I create lots of videos on cybersecurity careers. So if this is your first time coming to my channel, don't forget to subscribe and check out the other videos. AI is going to touch each and every subdomain within cybersecurity. Whether you're in defensive security, offensive security, or GRC, any subdomain within cybersecurity, AI is surely going to be involved in your everyday work. Let's talk about first and the most popular use of AI in cybersecurity: automated alert and investigations. In a security operations center, the SOC analysts are flooded with thousands of alerts. They deal with these alerts every day, investigate each one of them, and decide if it's a false positive or a true positive. And this is usually a very overwhelming number, which is why SOC analysts often lead to something called as burnout. AI is actually helping to automate these alert investigations. For example, no matter which incident comes up, there might be certain steps that the SOC analyst takes no matter what. These are the exact steps which are being automated now by AI. It is done using automated workflows, playbooks. AI can do a lot of things. It can help you understand the previous investigations and how the current one is different from them. It can actually correlate the different events and put them all together in the same place. It can actually use machine learning, enhance UEBA, which is user behavior analytics. This is actually leading a lot of people to think that SOC analyst roles are going to be replaced by AI. Maybe in the very future, yes, but right now, the SOC analysts who develop their skills and are updated with everything happening, they won't be losing their jobs. SOC analysts who don't have the updated skills and are still doing the repetitive old tasks might lose their jobs. If you develop your skills in playbook creations, understanding how AI and ML is actually working in the SIM solutions, the XDRs, firewalls, if you understand how AI is playing an important role in changing the attack landscape and the cyber attacks happening out there, then I'm sure you won't face a lot of difficulty to maintain your SOC analyst role. Now let's talk about the second use of AI in cybersecurity right now. This is for assisting offensive security and pen testing operations. AI is also being used in the offensive side of security. Pen testers are actually using AI to automate a lot of stuff. They are automating bug bounty, they are automating scanning and exploitations. I've actually previously made a video on AI-powered pen testing, and that is a really interesting video. If you haven't seen that, check that out after watching this video. But what pen testers are doing is, instead of manually checking hundreds of systems and scanning everything in the network, they are actually using AI to automate all these things. It actually helps pen testers focus on the actual critical work and not be stuck behind the automated and repetitive tasks such as scanning environments or creating reports. It doesn't really replace human expertise, but instead, it makes the process much more faster, reducing manual tasks. The third use of AI in cybersecurity is to actually generate automated threat intelligence analysis. Whether it's an offensive security analyst or a defensive security analyst, everybody uses threat intelligence to actually gain external intelligence and knowledge. Now, what AI can do is actually it can collect massive amounts of data from the different threat feeds that are available out there, identify the different attack patterns and trends, and actually collate all of this information and present it to you in a much easier way, rather than the analyst having to explore and go to different threat intelligence platforms and manually search for the intelligence on those particular IOCs, which is either IP addresses or hashes or domains and URLs. This also gives security teams a greater context about who might be behind the attack. What are those IOCs related to? Are they related to a particular APT group? So this gives organizations a strategic advancement. Although organizations may not be specifically using AI-related threat intelligence platforms, but the SIEM solutions or the other tools they are using within their organizations will have AI capabilities inbuilt already. The fourth use of AI currently is for generating documentations and reports. This is a big one because not every analyst likes to create reports and documentations. Let's say you are a pen tester, you've conducted your entire pen test, you're good at that, you enjoy that work, but in the end, you have to create a report of all of your findings. Let's say you are a SOC analyst or an incident responder, you finish the entire investigation, you find out the root cause analysis, but now you have to actually write a report. And not everybody enjoys that. And that is where AI comes in the picture. AI is being used to automate things, to actually reduce the human error, save a lot of the analyst's time to actually do the critical tasks instead of wasting them behind doing something repetitive and which feels like admin work. Now, the fifth use of AI in cybersecurity right now is for assisting risk assessment and compliance related tasks. AI is also being applied in GRC. You may not hear about it as much as you hear the alert automation or the automated pen testing, but AI is being used in GRC as well. Firstly, GRC is a documentation heavy subdomain. So that relates to the point number four we just discussed about automating some of the documentation and the report work. Also, a lot of the companies out there are actually using AI to speed up their audits, to speed up their regulatory assessments, and to make the risk assessments more data driven as well. Humans still have to obviously make the decisions and go through everything and decide the policies and all of those good things, but AI is just reducing the repetitive and the boring data. So, to wrap up, these are the top 5 areas in cybersecurity where AI is being used right now in 2026 and will be used in the future as well. Number 1, automating alert investigation and response. Number 2, assisting pen testing and offensive security. Number 3, analyzing the threat intelligence. Number 4, generating documentations and reports. Number 5, helping with the GRC and compliance aspects. I hear a lot of people being worried to get into cybersecurity careers because they think AI is going to replace the jobs. And let me just focus on this point once again, even though it was mentioned earlier, AI won't really replace human beings, but instead make our work faster and better. If anything, these are the good parts of AI, how it's helping us in our daily work. But there is a bad side to AI too, where AI is increasing the attacks and the threat landscape. Since AI is being used more and more in organizations and around the world, so is the threat from AI increasing. And to actually protect from this threat of AI, we will in turn need more analysts, more expertise on AI, detecting AI powered attacks, using AI tools to make lives better and more productive. So the key point is that no matter what subdomain in cybersecurity you want to get into, you don't have to be too afraid of what's going to happen in the future with this. Instead, focus all of your energy to actually read more about the AI attacks happening, try to explore AI tools, and keep up to date with the latest stuff happening in the cybersecurity community. If this video has helped you, comment down and let me know if you are now feeling much more positive about AI and cybersecurity. And also let me know if you have already explored some of the stuff we spoke about today. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much, and see you next time.